Welcome to the race.
Welcome to the marathon.
Just originally, there wasn't much to say. The kids laughed and played until they all saw Jane. We could tell they were struggling, something was troubling. We all were puzzling till we saw what was happening. Drawing red or white, he put up a fight with any second night. We put him to bed, not a lot was said. Before we all could tread, that was when she said, no.
20-mile mark of the Cleveland Marathon.
Welcome to the Cleveland Cultural Gardens.
Welcome to Cleveland.
Finisher in the Rite Aid Cleveland Marathon. What's your name?
Joanna Johnson.
And where are you from?
I'm from Oberlin.
A local.
Yeah.
It's always exciting for people when a local makes the podium. So tell us about your race.
It was a really great day. This is my third marathon and I had a goal time of 2:50, and so I tried to go out cautiously and was really lucky to meet up with someone along the way who seemed to be running about the same pace, and we said, hey, what's your goal for today? And he was running, going for a 2:49, and so we said, all right, we're going to stick together and see what we can do. And he was really helpful. He's run this race before and just kind of kept me going, you know, telling me, okay, you got it. This half mile is a little bit uphill, just like take it easy. So that helped a lot. And then by about mile 20, we kind of went our own direction. And I knew with the 6 miles to go, it was going to be painful no matter what. So I just went for it and, yeah, took my chances, and it turned out well. So
it sure did. It's very exciting, but you had conditions. You had heat. You had wind. How much did that affect you today?
I definitely prefer running in the heat rather than the cold. I'm actually originally from Northern California. I went to college in Oberlin and have been there since. And the cold has always been a challenge for me. I always knew when there was a big race and it was going to be cold, I was going to have to work a little bit harder. So I was actually relieved, and everybody else was really worried about the temperatures. I was happy to know that I was going to be plenty warm. So
it's your day.
Yeah, I guess so.
We have here the elite athlete coordinator for the Rite Aid Cleveland Marathon, Half Marathon, and 10K, John Tope.
Hi.
Hi. What a great race today. My goodness, there's a lot of interesting stuff happening. Let's turn to the marathon. The women's race was has some interesting things going on in it, but one of them, last year's winner, Mary Acor, came in second, but she's been racing every week, it seems.
Yeah, she races a lot, but she did that last year too and came in and won, so I wasn't too concerned about that. I think the problem, I mean, she ran much faster this year, and I think the problem was, as Tony Revis said at the finish line, she ran into a fresh pair of legs. Sarah Kiptoo was not as, you know, hasn't raced as much, so she's a little bit fresher. I mean, 11-minute PR, I mean,
who gets those?
Yeah, my goodness, you know, what a performance by Sarah Kiptoo.
And the men's race, you had a couple of prior winners here today.
Yeah, we did. We had some prior winners, and a lot of the guys have run here before, and so they know the course and everything. And again, you know, when you walk outside and you see the wind, and then you're at the finish line, and it goes from yellow conditions to red, and you're going, oh man, where are they? You know,
and there were long spaces in between first, second, third, and women.
Right, but to have, you know, I know the 233 is a great performance for the women, but you know, I'm just thrilled with 217 for the men. You know, it. What a great, that again is a great performance.
Well, we have a very exciting story this morning at the Rite Aid Cleveland Marathon. We have a debut marathoner, and I understand you're 16 years old, is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
And your name is?
Alana Hadley.
And you're from?
Charlotte, North Carolina.
And you have been training as part of the 2016 Olympic Trials project, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So, what was it like this morning, your very first marathon?
Crazy. The first half, I was right on pace up to the half. I was starting to feel tired, but I knew I was halfway. I was good to go. Went around a sharp turn right after the halfway point. Stepped in a big pothole all of a sudden. And my hamstring kind of seized up a little bit on me. And so that last half was brutal. Because in my head, I was like, I'm going to finish this race, and I want to get under. I kept thinking to myself, I'm like, okay, 250 instead of 240, just 250. Didn't work. I was like, okay, under three. And then I just focused on that. I was like, under three, because it just got progressively worse and worse. And that last 6 miles was brutal.
And I believe you have a 115 half marathon under your belt.
116.41.
Okay. Well, pretty, still really good.
Thanks.
So congratulations on finishing the race today. And we're really looking forward to the rest of your career.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
Okay.